In these sessions, I'd like to explain the linear velocity and accelerations. We consider the rotation of the rigid bodies. So all the points inside of the rigid body making a circular motions around the axis of rotations. So this is the axis of rotation. So if you consider the point inside of the rigid bodies, this point is used to be the in this position. Then distance is expressed r. Also that this distance should be the r. Then for the point to travel is expressed r times the theta. Theta is the angle between the x-axis and the position vectors of the red point. So distance for a red point to travel is expressed s equal r theta. So from this equation, r doesn't change, because we assume the rigid body object. So ds equal r d theta. So small distance is expressed, ds is expressed r times d theta. Velocity is defined, distance divided by time dt. So if you substitute this ds is here, so it becomes r d theta dt. D theta dt is omega. So velocity is expressed r omega. Then we'd like to consider acceleration. Linear acceleration is defined. In this case, the object is making a circular motion around the z-axis. So we choose the z-axis is the axis of rotation. Then tangential component of the acceleration, should find the derivative of v with respect to times r d omega over dt. And then d omega dt is angular acceleration. So r alpha is equal to the tangential component of the acceleration. This corresponds to the change the magnitude of the velocity. Rotational speed is increasing or decreasing by this a subtans. Also, centripetal component of acceleration. Linear accelerations can be expressed b squared over r. R is a distance from the axis of rotation, over r omega squared. This corresponds to the change the direction of the velocity. So linear velocity is expressed omega cross r. This is a cross product or vector product. By using the vector product, we discover the linear velocities. Then using this expression, we could discover the linear acceleration vectors by find the derivative of b with respect to times. So you can use this v and substitute here. This is the definition of the acceleration. Then first one is the derivative of omega with respect to times and the not derivative of r. Times the not derivative of omega times the derivative of r. We use a formula for the product of the two functions. First terms correspond to the actually alpha. Alpha cross r. This is actually equal to the v. Then we can substitute. V is omega cross r. Then you can find the omega cross omega cross r. Actually is equal to the omega times omega dot r. This is scalar product. Minus omega square. So from these equations, you can create two terms here. In the first terms, it corresponds to the a sub tan. So I show you. And the last terms correspond to the a sub lat, centripetal component of the accelerations, linear acceleration. Second terms, if the omega is perpendicular to the R. The axis of the rotation is perpendicular to the radial vectors to the point in rigid bodies, then this term is going to be zero because omega scalar product of the omega and R becomes zero. So sometimes this second term is going to become zero. Then we need to consider the first term and the last terms. I show the first term corresponds to the tangential component of the linear acceleration. And the third terms correspond to the centripetal component of the linear acceleration. This is the end of this session.